What's going on, homies and homies? It's your boy RC here. Get ready to get into this video by WWE's official channel called Most Memorable Debuts of 2017 WWE Top 10, December 30th, 2017. Long title, I know, but you know what? We all have those memories of 2017 as far as wrestling goes, with the debut of Samoa Joe as well as a lot of numerous other people. We've seen a lot of people being pushed in 2017, like Braun Strowman, Jason Jordan with that stupid Kurt Angle's My Father storyline. You know, let's go ahead and get into the video. Let's go ahead and just hop into it. What memorable debuts? Bobby Roode.
Here comes Tag Team.
Tag Team, I forgot about that. Okay, I think some people expected it. At the same time, they expected Ty Dillinger to debut, but at the same time, you're like, because you never know what happens in Royal Rumble each year. Like, you just never know. But I wonder what's going to happen in Royal Rumble this year. It's almost Royal Rumble time again, so yeah.
It's a perfect
I just
10
wonder.
In the 10th position. Ty Dillinger is in the Royal Rumble match. I can't believe it.
Tag made I forgot about the revival.
Dash Wilder, now the legal man. Dawson just eats a boot from Woods.
And Woods has no idea.
And look at that shatter machine! The revival! Victorious! And their debut on Raw.
You know, I'll say I forgot about the revival for a simple fact. They came in the beginning of 2017, stayed on the main roster for like a month or two, and then got injured. Both of them got injured. It's crazy. It's crazy how that happened, because they were on such a roll. I really thought they were going to take over tag division, and then they got injured. I mean, injuries can plague you, especially when you start to get on a hot streak like that. But let's go ahead and get back to the video.
Wait a minute. Logan, Riott, and Morgan are back.
Naomi and Becky Lynch backstage earlier tonight.
What is going on tonight?
Yeah, when these girls debut from NXT.
Oh, my God.
I feel like they could have been brought in better, in a way, instead of the way they were brought in, because they just copied.
You can hear the NXT
chants.
These three women
just copy and paste it.
Running roughshod over the SmackDown Women's Division tonight.
I thought they meant on main roster. I didn't think they meant like. We all know who Aleister Black is. If you don't, you need to start watching some indie matches, and you need to start watching NXT, because Aleister Black is definitely, all the hype is there for a reason, because Aleister Black is a beast. I've seen NXT, what was it, week before last on USA Network, it was dope, I loved it. I loved it. He's actually a good wrestler. I feel like he might be underrated by some people, but he's a good wrestler.
I'm back.
Mandy Rose and Sonya Deville. Oh, yeah.
I didn't come alone.
Oh, wait a minute, who the is it? It's from behind!
Sonya Deville and Mandy Rose.
Oh, and now Sasha Banks goes right after Mandy. And Deville with a kick to the boss. And Mandy taking out Sasha Banks. And Paige was right, she didn't come alone.
She looks different than like the she did in that what last season of Tough Enough Mandy
and
Rose.
Bobby Roode, the glorious DDT.
Oh, good night.
Welcome to SmackDown Live.
You know what? The glorious DDT is nothing but another version of education. The only thing is Edge isn't one executing it. I feel like Bobby Roode should go back to using the Roode Bomb, aka the Death Valley Driver. I feel like that really fit.
Here is your winner, Bobby Roode!
Shinsuke Nakamura with his seizure lights. I love it. Love it. I shouldn't be so rude like that. Shinsuke with his, well, it is seizure inducing lights. I feel like it's just going from black and white flickering real quick. I feel like it is. A nice slap to the face.
Oh, wait a minute. There's that.
I'm surprised they have Emma like being featured, especially after the entire thing with Leo Rush's tweet about how Emma wasn't ready for Asuka. I can make so many jokes about that.
Absolutely hypnotic smile of Asuka. It'll buckle your knees if you know what's coming next.
Oh. And there's that. I don't mean keep pausing the video too much. But 6 days after this, she was released from her contract, which I feel like is wrong in the first place. Because Emma, believe it or not, is a good wrestler, very underrated. And I feel like she had what it takes to be on main roster. Because before she was released, she was on a hot streak. She had came back from that horrible Emelina gimmick. She also came back from injury, if I'm not mistaken. She just had so much going for her, and then they released her.
Emma!
Like, some releases were unnecessary. She is a joy to watch. I don't care what they say. They could have found room for her.
He defeated one of the top champions in NXT history, Bobby Roode. What the hell?
It's Fishing O'Reilly!
They made their presence.
Bobby Fish, Kyle O'Reilly, Adam Cole's gonna come from behind.
During the NXT
and you know what, Adam Cole, for those who are watching the Ring of Honor, he definitely did his thing in Ring of Honor.
What the hell?
He was definitely underrated in Ring of Honor, too.
Absolutely. And Bobby Fish, no strangers to one another.
What is going on?
Super kick by Adam Cole.
We all know where Samoa Joe is. Samoa Joe, he's going to come from out of nowhere and just attack. Oh, man. You know what? Samoa Joe's debut. If he hadn't got, because he was injured too for a while. It's like a lot of people that debut from like, go from debut on NXT and then they make their debut on the main roster. They end up injured within less than a year. Seems like, or a little over a year. It's just crazy.
Death is their pet.
Oh, my God. Who the hell is, who the? Oh, my God. It's Samoa Joe. Samoa Joe from NXT.
The two-time NXT champion. So Samoa Joe is on Monday Night Raw.
Is heavy. Samoa Joe attacking and assaulting Seth Rollins.
Samoa Joe is now trying to destroy Seth Rollins.
And you know what, I'm sorry I have said this, but announcers just make it like, they make it obvious they're reading off a script now. It seems like everything they do is like somewhat half-hearted. It's not like genuinely shocking. Like, the way it sounds, not genuinely shocking. The way it used to be, like, back in the 90s, early 2000s. But then again, that was during the Monday Night Wars. I can't keep comparing now to the way things were 16, 17 years ago. But I'm just saying, make it a little more, you know, make it a little more special. Don't just be like, because you can just tell, look at a piece of paper like, oh my God, who's this? Like, they're looking at a piece of paper like, oh my, like, chill. Just seem genuine when you're explaining something or talking about something, you know. But hopefully y'all enjoyed the video. Remember to smash the like button, leave a comment, subscribe, share, suggest me, type the video you want to see in the comment section down below. Until next time, much love, stay cool. Peace, y'all.